So in the last video, we saw that the elliptic planform without any twists produces the elliptic lift distribution. And so it raises the question, what if we just study wings without twists? So let's look at just planform effects on lift and induced drag. Okay, so that simplifies our general solution just a little bit. So here's our general system of equations. And this is used to compute the A sub n, the coefficients A sub n. And what that depends on is this distribution of twist, where alpha of theta is the geometric twist and alpha L0 of theta is related to the aerodynamic twist. So if we say that these are not functions of theta and that they're simply constants, then that simplifies this equation a bit. And what happens is we can actually divide this through and just put a 1 over here, divide this through to the other side. So we have a sub n divided by that, so these coefficients divided by that, and then this original equation, then we're just going to multiply alpha minus alpha L0 out front, and then use, instead of capital A sub n, we're going to use this little a sub n. That means that we're just looking at the planform. Okay, so what we'll get then is for gamma of theta, we're going to have 2b v infinity times alpha minus alpha L0 times a summation from n equals 1 to capital N. We're going to call these little a sub n's sine of n theta, where those little a sub n's can be computed from this lower equation, a sub n sine of n theta times 4b over cl alpha c of theta plus n over sine theta. Okay, and we divided that whole thing through by this alpha minus alpha L0, where it was independent of theta, and so we just have a 1 there on the right hand side, and now we have these little a sub n's that our solution depends on. Okay, and so once we've found those little a sub n's, we can show that the lift coefficient is can still be written as a lift slope times alpha minus alpha L0. Again, that's just a constant or independent of theta. And CL alpha, the lift slope of the wing, is equal to CL alpha tilde over 1 plus CL alpha tilde divided by pi times aspect ratio times 1 plus, we're going to call this a kappa L, okay? And we'll define kappa L here in just a second. And then our induced drag, CDI, can be written as CL squared over pi aspect ratio E sub S, our span efficiency factor, where E sub S equals 1 over 1 plus, and here we're going to define a kappa D, okay? Kappa L and kappa D both depend on our Fourier coefficients, on these little A sub N coefficients. So kappa L is 1 minus 1 plus pi aspect ratio over CL alpha tilde times a sub 1 and divided by 1 plus pi aspect ratio over CL alpha tilde, so the sectional lift slope times a 1. Okay, so that's kappa L and kappa D. Remember, so this makes sense because the lift depends only on that very first coefficient, again, a sub 1. Kappa D depends on all of them. In fact, kappa D is now the summation from n equals 2 to n of n times a n over a 1 squared. Okay, so these are kappa L and kappa D, and they go here into the induced drag and the lift slope equation, which then gets used in that lift coefficient equation to get the actual lift coefficient at some operating alpha minus alpha L0. Now, something to notice here is that the lift slope of a finite wing is always less than the lift slope, than the two-dimensional lift slope of the section. Okay, so just neglecting kappa L here for just a second, we notice that the lift slope here of the finite wing is equal to the two-dimensional lift slope, the section lift slope of the airfoil being used, which is usually close to 2 pi from thin airfoil theory. That's what that's predicted to be. But then it's 2 pi divided by 1 plus 2 pi over pi aspect ratio. Now, as aspect ratio gets really large, let's say it gets so large that this term goes to 0, then we get back to the lift slope of the two-dimensional airfoil. Okay, so in the limit, as aspect ratio approaches infinity, the lift slope of the main wing approaches the lift slope of the section, which makes perfect sense, right? As we have a really long wing, then the lift slopes of the section will be equal to the lift slope of the main wing. But if aspect ratio is smaller, then this term becomes larger, and it's a 1 plus some finite value, which means that we're going to decrease the lift slope. So where this is usually on the order of or really close to 2 pi, so 6.28, a lot of times for the lift slope of a finite wing, we'll get somewhere between 4 and 6, 4.5, 5.5, 6, somewhere in there, instead of 2 pi or 6.28 that we would for the section lift slope. Okay, so this is the solution for wings without twist, and now we can use this to study planform effects. So we already know that the elliptic planform is a really efficient planform. In fact, for the elliptic planform, kappa L is 0 and kappa D is also 0. Okay, so for the elliptic planform, you can just drop those out and you recover these equations here where kappa L and kappa D are 0. But for other planforms, we're now going to study their efficiency in terms of the kappa L and kappa D compared to the elliptic wing.